Today we are going to answer the question as to why the United States decided to use an atomic bomb on Hiroshima in Japan and result in this. Klatz, welcome back to the city of Hiroshima. We are here in Japan in the Hiroshima prefecture, in the city of Hiroshima. And today we're filming a different video. Tone is going to be a little different than the rest of the vlogs here from Japan because we're going to be taking a little history lesson into the dark past of Japan and this city specifically. As you can see, the ruins behind me, this is the Hiroshima Atomic Bomb Dome. This place is rooted in a lot of history from World War II and from when the atomic bomb was dropped here in the city. We are going to be talking about it today. We're going to be digging into the history of the city. We're going to be digging into the history of Japan. And I told myself, if I ever get the chance to come out to Hiroshima, I would not pass up on the opportunity to educate people about what happened here. Alright guys, so as part of the memorial here for the Hiroshima atomic bomb attack, there's actually a whole kind of plaza with different sites and stuff to see. There's an actual atomic bomb dome, there's this peace clock tower. We're going to talk about each part and move around here and give you guys the history behind each piece. So here in the peace clock tower, there's actually a chime every morning at 8:15 in the morning in commemorance for the attack that happened in 1945. The clock chimes a sound out of these speakers. It says here on the plaque that it's a peace prayer. I can't understand if the peace prayer is a figurative way of saying chime. We haven't actually heard it yet, so I don't know exactly what it is, but it chimes out some kind of sound. There's two loudspeakers on top. Point of it happening is the chime will be so loud that it'll go into the most remote areas of the world and send a message of peace to the entire earth. So nothing like that will ever happen again. Behind me as well is the Hiroshima Bell of Peace. It was actually created in the 1960s as well, in 1964, and when it's chimed and it's hit, peace spreads throughout the world, and so that all nuclear arms are disarmed around the world and disappear. Okay, so before we head on in there, we're going to break it down for you guys and give you guys a quick, not full-on history, but a quick history, brief history to go over why all of this happened. Why was Hiroshima even hit with an atomic bomb? What was Japan's part played in World War II? So if you didn't know, Japan was not always the country that it is today. Actually, for a very long time, it was not even close to what it is today. It was a very aggressive nation that caused havoc and destruction in a lot of places. I've heard stories from many Asians while traveling here in Asia of people who still to this day hold a grudge against Japanese people, or their family held a grudge against Japanese people because of the acts committed during World War II. We're referred to them as the Nazis of Asia. Similar to Germany in World War II, you know, with the Nazi movement, how the country has today taken a complete 180 turn and is stepping obviously in a more positive future. The same kind of situation hit Japan. In 1941, when Japan decided to enter World War II by attacking Pearl Harbor in Hawaii, it was a surprise attack against the Americans. They used very aggressive tactics, and one of them known as the kamikaze method, which was to take your plane and to fly it into something, commit suicide with it, causing an intense amount of destruction by killing yourself and then causing as much destruction on the side as well. A war like this, from a lot of people's perspective, especially people who study World War II, say it was inevitable. It was going to happen either way. Japan was under the power of an emperor who was known to be very authoritative and very violent in the sense of what he wanted to do to support Japan and to prop Japan up. And even when all things were going downhill, he used that as a method to kind of push Japan in the wrong direction. So on September 4th, 1941, a cabinet of Japanese met to consider attacking Hawaii and Pearl Harbor. And they decided, and this is a direct quote of what was said in that cabinet, "Our empire, for the purpose of self-defense and self-preservation, will complete preparations for war, resolve to go to war with the United States." So once again, Japan was fighting wars in China and Hong Kong. And then finally, when it attacked Pearl Harbor and Oahu in the United States and Hawaii. And it just seemed to be that Japan had its foot in a lot of different places and was trying to fight a bunch of different battles at the same time with little money, little support, and little motivation from its people. So before the atomic bomb was ever used, the actual United States Army, the US Army, bombed and air raided Japan a bunch of times. There were all kinds of incinerations and burnings of entire cities in Japan before the atomic bombs were ever used. Strategic bombings and bombings that used to burned down buildings and very, very specific bombs that were developed during that time that were shown to use an incredible amount of damage. There was one bombing in Tokyo that a lot of people don't even know about that caused the death of like 100,000 people. And the overall number is estimated between 350,000 to 500,000 extra people died in just raids all over Japan. But regardless of this, Japan kept on pushing over and over and over again, and nothing persuaded them to stop until the US decided to drop two atomic bombs on the cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. In the matter of minutes, these two bombs single-handedly killed 120,000 to 140,000 people between these two cities. It is believed that in Hiroshima, 120,000 people died, and 80,000 died in Nagasaki by the end of 1945. After that, Japan surrendered and ended World War II. Emperor Hirohito actually went on the radio and declared an ending to the war, a surrender of the war, and after that, a new period in Japan was ushered, which was called the Occupied Japanese Period. By many different aspects and international pressures, Japan went through a huge shift in that period of time of changing cultures and changing different things about the country. The country's name was forced to change from the Empire of Japan to just Japan. And essentially, the country was beginning its process of reforming. There are still people who have dealt and are dealing with deformities and radiation poisoning, and they've taken this with them to life and developed different diseases from stuff like that. And it's even affected people's genes in a sense of when they've had children, that their children have come out with certain deformities or diseases or problems because of the attacks that happened here. And today's point of this video is not to persuade you into a certain point of whether Japan was right or the US was right. History was history, and World War II marked a crazy period of time on planet Earth. And what happened had happened. That's history, that's rooted in history. And a lot of people will agree that it had to happen for Japan to change and for the world to change. And obviously now you can see Japan's moving in such a positive light. It's an innovator and a change in the world, a beautiful light in the world in Asia. After that full-on discussion of World War II, we're going to head on in to the building right behind us, to the Atomic Dome of Hiroshima, and do a little bit of exploration in there. So behind me is Hiroshima's Prefectural Industrial Promotional Hall. This behind me is Hiroshima's last surviving building that was the closest point to the atomic bomb's detonation. It has now been designated as a World Heritage Site and is actually where Hiroshima's Peace Park is. And this is kind of like the center point of the entire Peace Plaza. It stretches over to the other side of the river where we had the bell and the clock tower. The dome on the top of the building, or the remnants of it, are designated to be called the Atomic Dome. And this park was opened up in 1955 as commemoration for the atomic bomb attack. It is a very eerie feeling walking around it and seeing the broken pieces of rubble on the ground. I mean, from the tiny rocks to the big pieces of stone that brick for the building, it's crazy. And on the plaque, they have a picture of what it looked like before the atomic bomb, after the atomic bomb. Everything around us right now was completely flattened. There's pictures of it. It looks insane. And there are even stories of people, and this is one of the most eerie things that I've ever heard about the atomic bomb attack, since it's the only time an atomic bomb has ever been used. It's the only time we really got to see the devastation of it and how it affects human beings. Silhouettes of people's dust from them vaporizing from the atomic bomb have been left on walls. And so it's crazy to imagine who was in this building at the time, who was walking around here in the streets at the time when this bomb went off. At the end of the day, Japan is an amazing nation, and I am so happy to have had the honor of visiting the city, visiting this country. And as an American, also an Israeli, but also an American, I love the fact that our two countries are now close allies and friends and are no longer at war. And I hope that that continues for the future and forever and ever and ever. Japan stays the beautiful and amazing way that it is now, and it only continues to innovate and become more and more amazing. With that, we're gonna end this video. We're gonna give you your Japanese word of the day, Eiwa, which means peace. Take that one and remember it for life. This was a very moving video to make, and I'm really happy and proud that we got a chance to make it. Make sure to check out the hostel that's hosting us down here in the description here in Hiroshima. Make sure that you come to Hiroshima to check them out. They're one of the coolest hostels. There was a whole hostel tour in the video yesterday from our cherry blossom video. So make sure you check that out. As it's raining right now, is a fitting ending for this video. Make sure that you check out the travelingcloud.com. If you want to support this channel, you can get some merchandise there, and turn on those notifications when you subscribe if you're new here. And we'll see you in the next one. I love you a long time. Goodbye, clads.